day.
Yeah.
Can you go on the crosshead?
Yeah, sure.
Is it?
Too many first aid boxes.
Thank you.
Is they were filthy, dirty and wet, and that's how they lived their lives. But,
well, you know, my hearing's okay. I don't have a problem with hearing, but I didn't understand the extent to which it was incomplete. Minus injectors, minus the piping that connects the injectors with the boiler supply. It didn't cross my mind that this was something that had to be replaced. And anyway, I found out that it was, 20 years learning curve, to get from that to that.
Is it a mile of pipe work on a steam locomotive?
It would depend on the type of loco, but these engines had nine separate pipe systems, one of which was the injector piping. There was another one for the sanding gear.
And it was driven by chains to reduce the maintenance, so the fireman or chef didn't have to go inside cooling over an oil bath. It was all in an oil bath. But the oil bath, because it was big, had to have various other rooms, so they had to have gaskets and seal that a bit. And also, where the axles went through, the axles had to move up and down. So the oil bath couldn't be totally sealed, unlike the sump of the car engine. Because he got this idea from the car engine design, using the chains to drive things in case it fell. So, but the oil leaked.
It was stopped everything.
Well, not quite, but pretty much. And they typically use about 2 gallons of oil. It's a 40-gallon sump. So it's really but not so good. No, they send it as a matter of. It's a bit embarrassing when you're working station.